everyone, today I'll be showing you how to set up a project. Before you begin, consider the definition of the product system, including system boundaries, the product lifetime, materials and the amounts used, manufacturing process applied to those materials, energy, water, fuel, and other materials consumed during use, end-of-life scenarios like landfill, incineration, and recycling, and transportation modes and distances across the supply chain. The instructions and data for the toaster project are available in your account. In this fictional scenario, a toaster company has asked us to design a greener toaster than their last year's model. The project overview tab displays three concepts: the reference, the concept we chose to be the final, and the concept with the highest improvement. Notice that the concept with the lowest millipoints might not always be the one you choose to be the final, because, in addition to being environmentally friendly, you should consider other priorities like product cost, supply chain issues, visual quality, usability, and ease of manufacturing. We've already set up our goals and scope using tips from the Learning Center, so let's jump over to the Concepts tab. Here we can see all our concepts, create new concepts that explore new strategies and solutions, and we can compare our results. Remember that it's always about comparisons, so which products are greener than other products. Let's take a look at our reference product. So here in the Overview tab, we summarize the impacts of the reference product. On the System BOM tab, meaning the product system build materials, we've organized the SBOM into three sub-assemblies. Little load here. The metal parts, the housing, and the packaging. I encourage you to include packaging in your assessments because most products get packaged. The materials can be entered in the manufacturing tab two ways. You can add a part manually, or you can import materials from a CAD or PLM system. So let's take a look at how to manually add a part. I'll start by naming the part. Let's make a handle. Then I'll come down to my materials, select the type of material I'd like. So I'm going to add aluminum. So you'll select the actual material, put in an approximate weight, because the design of the handle hasn't been completely finished. I'll tag it as an estimate, and I'll enter a comment about the source of the part for future reference. I'll add that to the system bill of materials and now add a process. I can see all the processes that can be applied to aluminum, and I can scan the columns to see the millpoint scores, as well as the CO2 equivalents, noticing while I scan that extrusion is wildly impactful. I'm going to select powder coating, and I'm going to check the amount and make sure it's also an estimate, and then add it to my system bill of materials. Now that we've entered materials and processes in the manufacturing phase, we can step through other tabs to enter other information about the product's lifecycle, such as consumables in the use phase, the end-of-life processes, and transportation, both in the supply chain and for the completed product. We can add those to our sub-assemblies and our parts. And that's how you set up a project. Make sure you subscribe to the Sustainable Minds channel for more demos and webcasts.